Only 60 tons.
That's a problem. I got too much fucking shit on here.
I know. It's just every horizontal surface becomes a shelf. Down.
Okay, stand back.
I got my steel-toed flip-flops on, sorry. Right. Bang! Ow! Yeah. Oh, you have a gauge. It would have told us how many tons it was. Is it clearing it?
You're about to stop. Did I move it?
Oh yeah! Oh yeah, it's kind of.
I don't think I moved it.
Well, this is a shiny. It's shiny just above.
I thought I did.
Oh, it went down. It went down 3/16, quarter inch.
Stand by.
Bang!
Yeah, it moved.
Oh yeah, it moved on.
Why did it stop?
Huh? The stupid thing is the bearing's good. My buddy's driving it to Mexico and he wants to put new bearings. He's selling it to a friend. It's not catching on anything. No, it's clear. Uh-huh. And they're good and friggin' tight.
That's what I'm saying. I don't. Had to move, but
yeah, it's down. It's down.
Why did it stop?
Maybe your press isn't big enough. Huh. Can feel it loose now.
That's what I'm wondering, if it's just the.
It's, you can see a shiny part of the spindle coming through. It's revealing a bit of a shiny part. I did bring the backing plates because those should go on and. When you're assembling it. There we go. No wonder my little baby press wouldn't do it. I don't think it'll fall down. It'll catch in the two logs of steel. Clank. That is one heck of a tight fit. Like I said, too bad. The bearing is good. There's a spacer and then there's the anti-lock brake ring. Clank. I watched some guy, he had this special big, like a 6-inch pipe that he used that went around here. It closed all the way around, it was perfect. A little too big.
Big enough.
Like the one the guy had that went there. What's that gonna land on top of? Just go between the steel, I see. Want me to move this?
Yeah, maybe I can
straddle it.
Well, I'll have to keep these in mind when I do it. If everybody brings me another one of these fucking things.
Toyota. It's a Tundra, Sequoia. Most of them are V8s. This one's a V6, but it's the big, it's the bigger model. But this one's got a V6. Too far over. Close it up a little bit. That's it.
Sometimes fucking three of these motherfuckers a day. Sometimes it's like, really? There's got to be somebody in this fucking north country doing it besides me.
I tried. My press is just too small. I cranked on it, hammered on it a little bit, and said, that's it. I'm done. It's a monster press.
Yeah, I mean, I've...
So it goes with the, I forget which way it went up. Is it going to sit flat? Yep, perfect. Japan, Koyo. It's funny, it came in a Timken box, but it says Koyo on it.
Must be another company that bought out another company deal.
Yeah. You got a grip on it?
Yep. It should be a big race like this. Bigger than this one. Somewhere. Oh, right there on the floor.
Yeah. The one that missed me. Press that in and the whatever you use to press it in gets stuck inside. I've done that before. You gotta tap it out, usually with universal joints. I should have brought the bolts over and thought about it. A monster snack ring. So you're just pushing it up against the lock ring now?
They give me the backing plate and the hub.
Yep. think there's room for the bolts. Would have been nice if I would have brought them, but.
We better hope so.
We welded them. A little drop of oil.
Yeah, get the spray bottle.
Yep. Yeah, there has to be room for the bolts because I removed them. Oh, wait, the seal.
Oh, fuck.
Uh-oh. Clunk. Here, bring it over. This seal is. Just tap it real easy with a hammer all the way around. What about that far one?
No, it's the same as the other one.
No, it's on the rubber. What about that giant sleeve, whatever that is? There you go. Where the hell did you find that thing? Sure, freaking ugly.
I pressed it off from something.
That is bloody ugly.
And I modified it to do something.
So you could, oh, you got a cut on the inside of it, but not all the way through the outside.
Yeah. Well, somebody cut that, but I had to notch it.
You get a wire in there or a tool? I know, I make tools and I forget. A year later, I wonder, what the heck, well, 10 years later, what the heck was that for? Oh, yeah. Yep. Yeah, you're done. Oh, nice chunks in there.
Is that it?
Yep. Yeah, you could hear it when it lands. You could hear the tone change. Bought a bunch of tools at a garage sale. I put the wrong gas in my car. I was driving the Corvair.
Snap on that motherfucker went about 3 times over the railroad tracks.
I bought
every regular. Time I use that cocksucker when I first got it, I hit my fucking thumb. I flung that motherfucker over by the tracks.
That's a big hammer.
Okay, let's try this again.
Do we have to put anything on? The ring goes on after the.
Oh fuck, we need the balance, the fucking backing plate.
Yep, let's not forget anything. Let's think this time. But I know that you don't need the bolts. I'll put them on after because I was able to remove them even though there was no backing plate left.
Okay, now what the fuck did I have? I had this. But this won't go through the hub. The hub's gotta go through it. I'm gonna have to use.
I'm gonna hold the. I got it.
Okay, pick it up a little bit. The other one. You gotta hold it flat.
What do you want me to do? Pick it up. Definitely not a do it at home yourself job.
can't believe I've never done one of these.
Yeah, you'd remember, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I would remember for sure.
Snap rings in place? You put the snap ring in?
Yep, snap rings in there.
I didn't remember seeing you do it.
There's the seals in there.
Yeah, I see the snap ring. I just don't want to forget. It's a bugger.
Okay, just tip it back. Go back and forth with it.
Yeah. Yeah, so we could, I'll let you do it so we could run in. Keep it square.
There you go. Just keep working it.
Yeah, so it keeps it square. There's probably an app you could put on your phone that'll do this. Oop, whoop. Just got tight. Are we interfering on something? These heads from?
Off the motor.
Oh, later model 454. Now for the, that's the ring that holds the ABS ring in place, huh? Still loose?
Yeah.
Huh.
The axle must hold it on there.
I don't know. So there's lots of room for the bolts. Junk.
Tessie!
Oh yeah. One lost dog. One lost dog. Crunch, crunch, crunch. Separator.
Bust that one.
Hmm?
I'm gonna bust that plate.
My plate?
Yeah, it's bending it fucking pretty good.
Well, it's just the bolts, really. You got a bigger one? Yours says made in China.
Oh, no, I got a bigger one over there.
Try it.
Thank you. come out of there. Problem, the press will do 60 ton, but...
But it's smooth. It's smooth.
If those plates break and this fucker takes me in the balls, I'm fucking done.
Yep.
So sometimes if you crack them a couple times...
Yeah, you whack it, it's got the impact. Cracks it loose. Oh, I get it. I understand. There it goes. That was a good idea to start it.
See, it gets to that one fucking point. Stops like that.
Yes. Yeah, probably the original bearing. This thing's never been apart.
No, but you'd think it would be smooth coming right out.
Once you start it. I agree with you, but same thing on both of them.
So it gets to that. Nothing in the way.
No explanation. Goes.